What's up, guys? It's Coach JB, and today we are checking out the Tennessee Volunteers. I've been a fan of Rick Barnes ever since he was at Texas, and they have some great sets that we're going to look at today. This is going to be our Vols Sideline Out of Bounds series. The first two sets that we look at are going to be paired up together. They're both called couple, and then we're going to look at one more set that's out of a box formation. The first setup in our series is couple low. The formation is going to be characterized with the 1 and 4 stacked on the elbow, the 5 man is going to be low, and the 2 is off on the other wing. The difference between couple low and couple high is going to be the route that the 3 man takes after he gets it into the point guard. So if we look at the film, you're going to see 1 and 4 stacked up on the elbow, and 1's going to lift up on a zipper cut. 3's going to throw it into him, and then he's going low road, so this way they can swing the ball around to him. And you notice that while 3 is taking that low road, 1 is dribbling the ball towards the opposite wing, 4 is going to follow him, and 2 is going to duck in for a stagger screen for the 3. The 2 is going to clear out of this stagger screen, and 4 is going to set a cross screen for the 5 man, who's also going low road. Now you'll notice that he gets bumped off his spot and doesn't have a chance to score, but I feel like at the high school level there will be a breakdown in communication and he'll have a scoring chance here. And the last part is my favorite. We're going to get a back screen from the 1 coming from up top, and the 4 is stepping in for a hammer screen for the 2 running to the opposite corner. The play is broken down by good defense from Kentucky, and they get an easy basket from the 4 man stepping into a jumper, but I really feel, again, at the high school level, there will be a breakdown of communication, and either this will be a layup, or you'll get a baseline drift to the corner. Checking it out one last time, we'll see 1 and 4 stacked, and then the 1 is going to come up on the zipper. 3's going low road, we're going to dribble it over and swing it to him, get that cross screen for the 5. He doesn't get it, so he gets the back screen for the 1, baseline drift in the corner, easy step in jumper. Our second set is couple high. Remember, like I said, the way that you tell the difference between the two of these is the direction that the 3 takes after he inbounds the ball. So it's going to be initiated the same way, 1 and 4 is still stacked, 1's coming up on a zipper, and then he's going to dribble the ball to the opposite wing. When we look at the film, we're going to see 1 is lifting up on the zipper cut, and then he's going to dribble the ball to the opposite wing. And then we're going to see an array of screens. 4 stepping in the screen for 3, 5's lifting up the screen for 3, 1 stepping in the screen for 3, and 2's going to hit him while he cuts to the basket off of this curl. And you'll notice he gets an easy layup. If we run this back to look at it again, the 1's going to lift up on the zipper cut, and then he's going to dribble to the opposite wing. Everybody's going to step in the screen for the inbounder. He gets an easy layup. Our last set that we're going to look at is called box. You're going to notice in the film that there's a little bit of a breakdown in communication, but coaches notice that they do figure it out, and players notice how they don't panic and get into the set anyway. So backtracking and looking at the fast draw, you're going to notice that both guards come up off of zipper cuts. After they clear out, the 3 is going to get it into the big man and then get it right back from him. Getting back to the film now, you're going to watch them figure it out, get into their box formation, come up off the zipper cuts. The 3 is going to inbound it to the 5 and then get it right back. Now there's some key reads here that make this play successful, and I want to go over them. First, you're going to notice that when the 3 drives, the 4 man is going to circle into the paint to give him a pass. You'll notice that the baseline drift man is holding up this defender, which means he can't help in the paint. And this defender actually gets caught up on the baseline drift guy as well, which allows the pass in the paint to occur. But the attack and pass from the 3 men cannot be understated. Looking at it one last time, getting that box, both come up off of zippers, get it into the 5, get it right back, drive baseline, you have the paint option and the baseline drift.